Greetings, fellow Earthlings. Welcome back to Delta Force 2. We are continuing with Operation Global Enforcement. Next up in line is Mission Fallout. We have pretty much disabled the terrorist uranium mining operations in Chad as best we could. We took back control of the mine, we took back control of the refinery, we rescued the scientists that they had kidnapped, and we even went ahead and took control of a shipment of refined weapons-grade uranium. Now all that's remaining is to take control of their smuggling hub so that they can't exactly smuggle any of the uranium outside of Chad. And that's pretty much what we really want to do here. Terrorist forces have taken over an airfield to use as a weapon smuggling hub. Secure the airfield and eliminate all hostile forces. Let's look at the mission briefing.
We've intercepted a radio transmission from an airbase near your location. They've reported that a large group of armed men have taken over the field. We believe this is an attempt by United Freedom to smuggle the uranium out of the country. Your task is to recover the material and clear the airfield of terrorists. Bravo and Charlie teams will insert west of the objective. Once the airfield is secure, proceed northeast to rendezvous with Black Widow for extraction. So far, we expect handheld weapons, but no armored vehicles. Good hunting.
Roger that. So looking at the layout, I suppose the grenade launcher would be the better choice for this mission. We have got extra ammo, and I would actually like to switch over from the Kevlar to, well, what can I take? A ghillie suit? That will make it easier for me, but maybe I'll just take the extra ammo instead. Item number 6.
All King Elements, move in and secure the airfield. Bravo, there are no civilians at the airfield. You are weapons free. If it moves, shoot it.
Roger, King 6. And, here we are. Attempting to play it cautiously. The main difficulty with this mission is the fact that there are hostiles all over the place that are essentially, you know, sharpshooters in their own right. And really? You decided to run? One for you too. And you have to clear lots of buildings. And you're essentially surrounded on all sides, almost. Took way too many shots. Far more shots than I would have liked for it to take, but hey, I'm not judging. So, if it works for you, it works for me. Enemy set there. But what I'm gonna do this time around is, I'm gonna get rid of the perimeter patrol here. And after that, I'm just gonna go ahead and get rid of those guys there. Another guy will be popping out soon. Yeah. And right here. Now what I'm gonna do next is I'm gonna clear out this building first. There are folks down in that building there. We need to be careful about how we approach it, but we also need to clear it. So here we are. I think the first enemy that we're going to find will be somewhere over here. Oh yeah, right there. You can see his arm poking out the window. And well, I'm just gonna go ahead and use the grenade launcher to try and thin out the herd a little. As much as possible, of course. Hopefully that did some damage. If it did not, well, I cannot do much about it.
King 6, this is Charlie 1.
Royal Charlie 1, you do what you have to. because I'm doing what I have to. There should be another guy here. No? Okay. Then I suppose there's a guy on top of me. On the floor above me, that is. Or on top of me. It helps if you walk instead. Should be more people here. Nobody? Oh, that's cool. I hear people. I can't see them, but I hear them. So, sometimes I feel like the game actually makes it so that these parts of the mission are easy for you. Wherein, like, you know, parts where you have to actually go ahead and shoot people out inside of buildings. It makes the enemy less aware of you. And hence makes the game easier for you. It says there's somebody over here, but I can't tell where they are. It says they're over here somewhere. But you know what I'm gonna do? I'm just gonna take out my grenade launcher again. And I'm gonna check a few grenades in. Okay. I think I may have protected my friends there. Which is something that I can definitely get behind. Toss one in there for good measure. And we're going to get out of this building cautiously. You already checked this corner, nothing here. I just hope that it doesn't lag at an inappropriate time like it did the last time around. I mean, to be honest, even now the game is lagging quite significantly. I don't know how I missed that guy, but apparently I did. Maybe he came over later. But, yeah. We also need to clear out the tower there, so it's best to be a little cautious about how we approach things. I see an enemy. Probably should have been a little more cautious in my approach. Clear. First floor is clear. Moving on to the second floor. Better to walk instead of running. Makes it difficult for the enemy to hear your footsteps. Difficult, not impossible, but difficult. I could have sworn there was supposed to be a guy there. Where am I looking? Yeah. Got that guy. So that is the guy I think I got when I tossed like a launcher grenade in here, essentially. I'm just gonna lay prone here until my frames return, and in case somebody decides to rush me. Which they did not, which I'm quite thankful for actually. I think both of these buildings are now officially cleared, but I'll still check the roof nonetheless. See if there's any angles for us to exploit that will lead us inside of this. Like any angles leading inside of the tower here. I do not think that is the case. Don't think we see any of the enemies here. There was that one guy that we took care of. I think we have successfully gotten rid of all the enemies on this in these buildings here. Clearing rooms is actually easier in this game than it was in the first. I feel like they sometimes just make enemies inside these rooms a little more dumb and give the players a little more time to react to these enemies. So there are supposed to be enemies in there, in the lighthouse, or rather the observatory. I don't know what it is. It's something. What is that? Foliage. I wonder if there are any enemies in there. Definitely enemies in here. I can just see them.
Bravo, there's a shooter in the tower!
I know.
Bravo, this is King 6. Check for hostiles in the hangar.
I was trying to run left, but I sort of missed. Like I got stuck on the wall. Thankfully that guy missed. Otherwise I would have been dead meat. Charlie 1 and Charlie... Oh wait, both of them are alive this time around. That's amazing. Maybe it's because I successfully got the other guy. The glass tends to bend when you're near it. What the fuck were you doing? Guy got shot in the dick. Funny. Okay, that is a no-no level. That is a very no-no level design. Who would... Who would think that this... Why would they think that this would be a good level design for this game? Just look at it. Just look at it. Okay. Yeah. Lucky. We got hurt in that as well.
To all King elements. Rendezvous with Black Widow at the extraction point. Black Widow, the airfield is secured. Move to extract. Roger, King 6. ETA is 2 mics.
ETA is 2 mics, huh? I'm just gonna stay in this little place here until the Black Widow arrives. See, there are more enemies coming. So that's why they said that the ETA was 2 mics, because they essentially wanted us to take out the reinforcements. Any and all reinforcements. I wonder if there's anything here, like some intelligence that we can gather for some sort of, you know, objective? Essentially check everything in the map in this game. So I actually recorded the secret mission for Operation Common Resolve before this, and well, it was pretty interesting. Quite a change of pace, to be honest, and pretty interesting. There's that plane there, the Cessna. That is apparently where our... oh no, wait, that's the objective. I think that is our extraction. Yes. Yes, it is. Yes, it is. Taking out the glass. Switching mags. Wait, is that... Yes, that is. That is an enemy. That's running right at us. And that's another enemy that's running right at us. Where are all of you guys coming from? My god. that guy got hit. Which is amazing. Which is amazing. So there was actually an element of danger to the extraction in this mission. Which is why you essentially maintain your range from buildings in this game. And wait things out instead of rushing it. Unless it cannot be helped. Because the Black Widow, I mean, in Delta Force 1, the Black Widow and your teammates for that matter, would actually help. They would help with a lot of things. But in this game, however, they don't really do that. That's our Black Widow right there, we don't want to shoot him. We can actually shoot our allies without any consequences. In this game at least. It was slick, it came as a total surprise to me in Halo 1. When I got bored and took out all the Marines and... well, they essentially started shooting at me. Not all the Marines, of course. Like, two of them. And the rest of them just started just shooting at me. And I was like, what's going on? Okay, I guess Charlie will hang back at the base and keep it secure from any retaliation, I suppose. I'm just checking for any code books or whatever. Oh no. Oh yeah, that counted as a win. Thankfully, because I tried getting on that truck and I accidentally pressed spacebar to restart that mission. But yeah, so that apparently did succeed. However, it has unlocked a new region on the map. And if I had to guess which region it was, so this is India, this is China, this is, well, Pakistan, Afghanistan. So this is on top of Afghanistan, Turkey? Kazakhstan, right. Turkey would be somewhere over here. I think that's Turkey. I was wondering why Turkey is like so large. So, yeah. So, this has unlocked a new mission for us. After completing Mission Fallout, we have unlocked Mission Voodoo, which is in Kazakhstan. So, apparently, United Freedom has taken over a number of close Soviet military bases. Now, what makes me wonder is, how are these guys so well financed that they can literally just take over military bases across the globe just like that? I mean, if they were local terrorists, I could still understand. But who in their right minds is giving them the resources to just go around the globe and, well, amass all this military might? So yeah, that sort of seems strange to me. Of course, maybe it's possible that this something like this happens in real life as well. However, I think this plot might be a little less realistic, since you don't really get to hear plots like this typically. I mean, there are sleeper cells and stuff like that, but sleeper cells don't exactly take over military bases and airfields and uranium mines and whatever, right? So, yeah. Anyway, when we come back, we will be targeting Mission Voodoo in Kazakhstan. Until then, thank you for tuning in, thank you for watching, and thank you so much for sticking around until the end. Take care. Farewell, fellow things.